A cantilever beam of length L carries a uniform distributed load of W over its entire length. Assume EI is constant. What is the rotation theta at the pre-end of the beam? What is the deflection at the pre-end of the beam? So when we see EI is constant here, meaning the beam is uniform in size. So when we see cantilever beam, it is a member with one end projecting beyond a point of support, free to move in a vertical plane under the influence of vertical loads placed between the free end and the support. So we have a uniform load of W here and a length L. When the vertical load W is applied here, in here, the pre-end of this beam tends to move downward. Thus, this deflected shape of a beam is created here. And the distance from the original position to its new position is called the deflection. And this is what we are looking for. Our theta AB is here. Now let us calculate theta AB with the aid of the moment diagram. So let us draw the moment diagram first here. The distance from the centroid of this diagram to point B is 3L over 4. And the area is equal to negative W L squared times 1/3 L. And so our theta AB is equal to So this is our theta AB. The deflection delta here is just the angle theta multiplied by the lever arm here and multiplied by this 1 over EI. So this is the deflection. A rectangular cantilever beam 100mm wide by 170mm deep is 3 meters long, has a Young's modulus of 200 gigapascal. A 40 kilogram mass falling through a height of 200 millimeter strikes and sticks at the free end of the beam. Compute the maximum deflection caused by impact. Neglect the width of the beam. So we have a cantilever beam of length 3 meters, 100mm wide and 170mm deep. 200mm above the pre-end of the beam is the 40 kg mass. The given mass equals 40 kg. This is the mass that falls here at a distance of 200 mm and gives impact force to this pre-end and produces deflection here, which is the unknown in this problem. The length of the beam is 3 meters and Young's modulus is 200 gigapascal. So the maximum deflection caused by the impact load is given by the formula here, delta. This static deflection here is the deflection of a cantilever beam due to concentrated load P applied at the pre-end of the beam. So this is cantilever beam and a concentrated force P here, and this is peak support. So the deflection here is equal to this one. Impact force created by the moving bus is just equal to mass times acceleration due to gravity. So our G is equal to 9.81. So this is the value of our static deflection. So we can now proceed to find the deflection due to the impact load.
Ang isipan
sa science o agha.